The dot product, level 12. In this final video on the dot product, we will prove the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality, triangle inequality, and the parallelogram law. Let's start with the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. Prove the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality for r squared and r cubed. This inequality plays an important role in different branches of modern mathematics. We can easily prove this inequality for the case where vector A and vector B are in R squared, the two-dimensional case, and R cubed, the three-dimensional case. Alright, let's first rewrite the dot product on the left side of the inequality with a geometric definition. Then, we go ahead and use the properties of absolute values and rewrite this expression as follows. Since the magnitude of a vector is by definition positive, we can go ahead and remove the absolute value operator from these magnitudes. Now, let's take a look at the absolute value of cosine of theta. Recall that the range of cosine of theta is between negative 1 and positive 1. In other words, the absolute value of cosine of theta is less than or equal to 1. When theta equals 0 or pi, the absolute value of cosine of theta equals 1, and the expression reduces to the magnitude of vector A times the magnitude of vector B. This makes sense since vector A and vector B are parallel and the dot product reduces to direct multiplication of the vector's magnitude. These are the angles for which the dot product is a maximum, when theta equals 0, and when the dot product is a minimum, when theta equals pi. Now, for the case when theta is between 0 and pi, the absolute value of cosine of theta will always be a number between negative 1 and positive 1. And when the absolute value of this number is multiplied by the product of the magnitudes of vector A and vector B, it will produce a value less than the product of the magnitudes of vector A and vector B. In essence, the value of cosine of theta between 0 and pi represents a percentage of the maximum or minimum value, which is equal to the magnitude of vector A times the magnitude of vector B. So this inequality is justified. And this ends the proof. Note that this proof is valid in the 2 and 3 dimensional cases because the dot product can be expressed in terms of cosine of theta, where theta represents the angle between the two vectors. However, in higher level mathematics, where we deal with higher dimensions, the geometric representation does not make sense, since it involves the geometric concept of an angle. So this method cannot be used to prove the inequality for general n dimensions. One must use the algebraic definition or component definition of the dot product to prove this inequality for higher dimensions. In this course, we will be dealing mainly with vectors in R squared and R cubed, so this proof will suffice. Alright, let's go ahead and prove our next inequality. Prove the triangle inequality. The triangle inequality states that the length of the longest side of a triangle is less than or equal to the sum of the lengths of the two shortest sides. This is a property that you probably learn in your first geometry class. The only difference is that this inequality is specific to vectors. Alright, we will prove this inequality by starting with the square of the left side of the inequality. Recall that the magnitude of a vector squared can be expressed as the vector dotted with itself. So we rewrite this expression as follows. Next, let's go ahead and use the distributive property for dot products and rewrite the expression. Then, we go ahead and replace vector A dotted with vector A with the magnitude of vector A squared, and do the same for vector B dotted with vector B. Then, we are going to use the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality as a way to introduce the inequality symbol. Notice that the middle term of this expression is 2 times the dot product of vector A and vector B. We already know that the dot product between two vectors is less than or equal to the product of the vector's magnitudes. So, if we were to multiply both sides of this inequality by 2 and add the magnitude of vector A squared and the magnitude of vector B squared to both sides, we obtain an equivalent inequality. Now we go ahead and replace the left side of the inequality with the magnitude of vector A plus vector B squared. We're almost done. We just need to rewrite the right side of the inequality. Notice that the right side of the inequality has the terms that make it resemble a perfect square trinomial. So we go ahead and rewrite this expression as the quantity of the magnitude of vector A plus the magnitude of vector B squared. The last step is to take the square root of both sides. Doing that, we obtain the triangle inequality. And this ends the proof. Alright, let's go over the final example. Proof: the parallelogram law. Alright, the parallelogram law states that the sum of the squares of the lengths of the diagonals of a parallelogram equals the sum of the square of its four sides. We can easily prove this by working with the left-hand side of the law. Let's rewrite the square of the magnitude of vector A plus vector B into its dot product representation. Then, we go ahead and use the distributive property for dot products. Next, we go ahead and rewrite vector A dotted with vector A and vector B dotted with vector B as the magnitude of vector A squared and the magnitude of vector B squared, respectively. Next, we essentially carry out the same process, but with the square of the magnitude of vector A minus vector B. So we rewrite this expression into an equivalent dot product form. And then we use the distributive property for dot products. We follow this up by rewriting vector A dotted with vector A and vector B dotted with vector B. Now, it is just a matter of substituting these expressions into the left side of the law. Doing that, we obtain the following. And then, we go ahead and collect like terms. Doing that, we obtain the right side of the law. And this ends the proof. Alright, and this ends the dot product series. In the next series of videos, we will focus on the third way of multiplying vectors, called the cross product.